Hey everyone, the Game Chief here. Today I'm going to be doing a video on moving all of your custom objects from the init.c file into their own files so it looks a little bit more like this right here, to where you have it separated all into separate files and nice and clean, versus the massive mess that this kind of looks like, to where there's just entries upon entries all over the place, making your init.c file absolutely huge. This video is sponsored by Calibre Servers. Calibre Servers provides dedicated machines with amazing configurations such as the Ryzen 9 5950X and the Ryzen 5 5900X. Don't need that much horsepower and don't want to break the bank. They also have lower spec machines and even VPS / KVM servers. And along with that, they also offer regular game server hosting as well. At Calibre Servers, the customer is king. All clients get direct contact with the owner via WhatsApp for emergencies. Check out their website and Discord server for more information and to find a plan that is right for you. Mention the Game Chief while ordering and use code THEGAMECHIEF for 10% off your first purchase. And don't forget to thank them for sponsoring these videos. So let's get started by going over some of the reasons why you would want to move your custom objects out of the init.c file. So the main reason why you would want to do that is to help clean up your init.c. So that way, instead of having, you know, just all this junk, you can have a much cleaner one like this right here. It just has a few lines regarding your custom objects, but that's about it. The rest is its normal init.c. This also protects you and your custom entries in case there's something like a game update that defaults your init.c back to your default values, so that way you're not losing all the objects that you've placed and where exactly they go. The nice thing about separating these into different files is that we can actually have, you know, multiple different files for each thing. So say you can have one file for a certain mod that spawns objects or that you want to spawn objects for, or say a certain area on the map. So say if you have like some additional trader stuff, you can go ahead and just have one file for that trader. Or if there's just a certain area on the map that you want to make changes to, you can, you know, name it the town name or something like that. That way it's a lot cleaner, you can kind of see what's going on, and you can easily add and remove these as well. And again, it's not all cluttered up in your init.c. So let's go ahead and get started. We're going to go ahead and close out of these files real fast here. Those were just some example ones. And as always, we'll be using server 0, which is our video series server. We're going to go all the way down to MP missions, init.c. And I have a couple different objects that we can go ahead and test this with and kind of show it. So in this case, I have the ATMs for the traders, and I also have a few Christmas trees. Obviously, most people have more objects, but we're just going to be doing these for the purposes of this video to make it nice and short and, you know, get the point across. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to the very top of our file. We're going to add a few blank lines, and then we're going to type the following. So we're going to use include, so it's going to include a file. So we have to use currenter / / mp missions. And then we have to use these / / the entire time. And then next we do what our mission name is. So we're using Chinaris Plus. So we'll go ahead and put that there. But if you're using a different map, you'll want to make sure that you use that map name. So I'm going to copy that out of there real fast. We'll paste that on in there. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to create, kind of like in the previous video that we did with custom types, I'm going to create a folder as well. And I'm going to name this custom objects. So we'll add that in there. And then now that we have that, we're going to need to create some files. I like to have a lot of separate files, but you could also theoretically throw this all in one file called custom objects if you wanted to. But in my case, I'm going to make this function here its own file. So I'm going to call this spawnObject.c. And then we'll also go ahead and create that in here as well. And what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and copy this entire function, because that's what it is. It's a function that spawns objects. We're going to go ahead and copy that. We're going to paste that in there. We're going to save it, and then we're going to close that. We do want this to be the first one, though, so that way that function can get defined, because all the spawning is going to rely on that function. So we're just going to do that. You can also make, instead of calling it a spawn object, you can call it a spawn object function, whatever works for you. So I'm also going to do another one here. So I'm just going to copy and paste this to make this easier. And this one I'm going to call ATMs instead. So ATMs.c. So we'll go and create another one in here. And now that we have this file, we are going to need to create a function. So we can do that with static. It's a void. And then we can call this whatever we want to. In this case, I'm going to call this function placeATMs. You do have to make sure that there's not already a function named this. In this case, I know for a fact there's definitely not anything called that. But you should definitely not be trying to use anything too generic or reusing the same thing. So we're going to go ahead and do that. We'll go ahead and open that up. It should hopefully be using some sort of text editor that automatically does some of this formatting for you. It just makes it a little bit easier. And then now that I have this function opened up, we can go ahead and copy all of our ATMs in. So I'm going to copy that, remove all those. And then we just put that inside of the function. So it's going to use that spawn object function, which we have already created, which is defined one line above with this include line here. And it's just going to go ahead and spawn all of these, and that's all this file does. So we'll go ahead and save that, close it. And now that we got those ATMs all set up in the ATMs.c file, we'll go ahead and do one more file for the Christmas trees. Again, we're only doing a couple here just for demonstration purposes, but you can definitely split this out as much as you want or as little as you want, because you could totally do one single file if you really wanted to. And I'm going to call this one just trees.c, and we'll go ahead and create that in here as well. And once again, we'll go ahead and create the function. So we'll do static void, and then the function name. So place trees. And we'll go ahead and paste those lines in there. We'll go ahead and save it. And if we go back to our init.c now, we can actually clear up these last little bits here. So back to how it normally was. And then as of right now, what we currently have is we have included all of these files, so they are there. But what they're only doing is they're just declaring these functions. So it's declaring placeATM, it's declaring, you know, spawn objects, all that. That's all this does. So in order to make these objects actually spawn, we need to run these functions. So what we'll do is in our main, so this is the main of the init.c, we're going to go down towards the bottom of it, which is, this is where it does like the time and date and all that. And then this line right here is the end of this else statement. So we're going to go ahead and press enter here. So we got to make sure we're not past this bracket here, because that's the ending of this entire main. We need it to be at the very end of the main, what we're going to do here. And then we're simply going to type placeATMs. I'm going to need a semicolon there. And then we're also going to do placeTrees. And a semicolon there. And essentially what we're doing here is we're just calling those functions that we created previously. So then we can just, you know, do all of our lines here for anything we want to spawn. And say if you're kind of debugging something, you can also just, you know, comment this out so it won't spawn. So it's really good for troubleshooting issues. So we're going to go ahead and save that. And then we're going to go ahead and restart our server and verify that everything is spawning correctly. And now that our server is back up, we can go ahead and join it again. Just to make sure that everything's working as we intended. Alrighty, and now that we are in game, we can go ahead and look around. And since we're already in the trader, we can see the ATMs here did spawn. And then we can see we have our massive Christmas trees out here as well. So it looks like everything spawned. So we can go in Alt Tab, go back into here. And just for a quick explanation, some people may be wondering why we don't have to call the spawn object function like we do with the place ATMs and place trees. And that's because inside of, let's see here, ATMs, it uses the spawn object function. So by including it at the very top of this include, it defines the function, and then these other ones go ahead and call it from there. So there's no need to add another line here to actually call the function, because it wouldn't do anything. And that's about it. It is possible that I forgot something, or there's some sort of error, anything like that. As always, check the video description and the pinned comment for any corrections at all. If you guys have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below or join my Discord server, which is always in the video description as well. Joining the Discord server allows you to DM me or to send messages to the support channel, which myself and others do jump in there to try to help you out. If you guys have any video suggestions, feel free to leave a comment below as well. And other than that, have a good one.